Hello everybody, Manithral here, and welcome to the weekly update video for our OSRS. Now this week we see poll 78 updates and more, which has rather interesting imagery, so let's see what we get into though. Before we get into it, we have some issues and hot fixes that were raised. At 12:55 GMT, they are seeing reports of strange occurrences happening around the Nightmare Zone. Some players have reported certain NPCs are missing from the customizable rumbles. The team is currently investigating that issue. At 12:15, players have reported not getting the weapon seed back when reverting the crystal weaponry, such as the bow, shield, and halberd. That has been hotfixed. And at 15:30 GMT, players have reported issues with new poison resistance in a few areas of the game. The team is currently investigating the issues in regarding to poison and its use in areas including changing NPCs' behaviors, areas like the Barbarian Assault, and more. They are looking to have a fix for these issues, but they will be keeping everybody posted as things go on. And then we go into the change log, which is poll 78 primarily. Well, I can't say primarily, there's quite a bit here. But for poll 78, they increase the number of coin pouches you can hold as reward from the medium, hard, and elite Ardarn diaries by 100%, 200%, and 400% respectively. Players can now recolor crystal armor, which one of the images it actually shows is that there is yellow, black, red, white, purple, blue, and green for those varieties, if you're wondering. Players now have the ability to make super extended anti-fire potions with the extended anti-fire potion and crushed dragon bones. Added the ability to return unwanted untradeables, except for the colossal blade, to the Giant Foundry shop for 80% of the original price. The catalytic tiara can now be used during the morning's end part 2 to access the death altar. Then we head into the wilderness boss rework. So there was some hotfixes that got brought up after the last week's update, and these hotfixes that are fixed, fix an issue where the Ursine Chain Mace special attack did no damage against wilderness bosses. Weird. Players can no longer avoid the slow effect from the Ursine Chain Mace special attack by holding the toggle walk run key. Adjusted loot tables for each of the reworked wilderness bosses, and how some people find these workarounds is amazing. This week, the drop rates for the wilderness boss reworks have been revealed. Players can switch between the powered staff and auto casting variant for the Themerian Scepter. Added mini-map icons for the escape caves. Fix an issue where Vanadis and Spindle's HP bars were moving during their attack animations, leaving the escape caves without auto retaliate turned on will no longer force your character to walk in a random direction. Secret to the North, a hotfix from last week, is fix a bug that incorrectly scaled the max hit of the Vanadis bow, a ricochet damage, at 50%. And this week, the newly introduced freeze resistance stat has now been rolled out to NPCs across the game. Poison resistance has also been introduced and rolled out across the game. However, remember, they are looking into an issue with that. Quest speedrunning batch 5, so X Marks the Spot and the Kingdom Divided, have been fully released on the quest speedrunning worlds. Black Knight's Fortress has been added into beta on the quest speedrunning worlds. Other changes consist of the Fairy Ring has been updated again to remove the glowing beam. The older version of the welcome screen has been decommissioned. The clan coffer's capacity has increased from 50 million coins, so players are reminded that other clan members with access to the coffer may withdraw funds without warning. Player and house servants are now less prone to getting stuck on scenery. The Fire Warrior Lazarus has no longer duplicated when two players summon him simultaneously. And PvP World Rota has moved to Period A, which is 539 US PvP World, 548 Germany High Risk PvP, 577 US Free to Play PvP, 559 UK LMS Competitive, and World 390 AUS LMS Competitive has been activated with this Rota. The PvP arena is using the Zerker loadout for the ranked duels slash tournaments. And as we discussed, the other stuff that was going on, but there was also some new changes that is going into this week's changes. For instance, the boss drops. This is one thing we haven't discussed yet. But the drop rate for the Broken Dragon Pickaxe is 1 in 100 per ore pack. However, some of the other stuff consists of, so the pet, normal bosses drop rate, and then there's also the lesser drop rate. But first up, we have the pet for the bosses, 1 in 2000. The lesser boss drop rate is 1 in 2800. Voidwalker piece is 1 in 360 for the boss, and 1 in 912 for the lesser. Dragon pickaxe is 1 in 256 for the boss, and 1 in 358 for lesser. Revenant upgrade item is 1 in 196 for the boss, and 1 in 618 for the lesser. Rings are 1 in 512 for the boss, and the lesser is 1 in 716. Dragon 2-H sword is 1 in 256 for bosses, and 1 in 358 for the lessers. So that is stuff to keep in mind. And I believe that is actually it as far as everything, other than we get into the cracked clue number 3. So they're back once again to hopefully give some more information. Okay, so first we have a dash dash x plus 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 underscore comma dash 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 x dash plus plus and dash 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 x plus 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 dash is how it will begin. With relevance to location the clue was found in. Something invisible is what you're looking for. Start at R and you will soon find some tin ore. More will follow, and four slices will have no intent. You'll notice your 2 minutes were well spent. The directions are important, but you will need more, as there are 8 directions rather than 4. Find the rest of them and then come back. Those will get you back on the right track. So, good luck with that riddle. One thing I do love about Jagged's is they do come up with some pretty awesome stuff like that. But that is actually it though for this video, so thank you guys so much for watching. And until next time, later guys.